can draw different drawing objects on the form in Visual Basic. Visual Basic provides two standard functions to draw on form. First one is called circle, as we can see in video. Second one is called line. These two drawing objects can be functions can be used to draw different drawing objects in the form. First of all, I will try to introduce you what is circle and what are its parameters. Circle objects requires x, y coordinates, radius, starting, ending point, and offset. These are the five parameters that are required to draw a circle in Visual Basic. Let us try to draw me. We can write me means form itself, or we can also write form one. Me.circle. Let's suppose x coordinate is 1000, y coordinate is 1000. We are giving radius as 2000. We can also provide color such as VB red or VB green, etc. Now this would be on form activate, because form is repaint after loading on activate event. We have to write here this method. Okay, we can clearly see this circle is drawn as the radius is more than the x and y coordinates. That why circuit is partially appeared on the form. This is the actual figure out the circle. We can also increase the draw width of the form to clearly highlight the circle on the form. For this purpose, we will use draw width property of form. Me.draw width is equal to, let's suppose, 10. Now we can see the circle is highlighted. Okay, now we will have to increase these coordinates that the circle will be much more visible. Okay, we can also use the same function form1.circle or main circle to draw ellipse in the Visual Basic. For this purpose, we have to set the offsets of the circle method. If we set the offset to 0.5, then it will draw an horizontal ellipse on the form. Let us try. We can clearly see that this is drawing horizontal ellipse on the form. If we want to shrink this ellipse, we will reduce the size by 0.2, 0.1, 0.4, 0.7. Normally it is used 0.5 to draw the horizontal ellipse on the form. If we want to draw the circle again, then it would be 1, the offset value. If we want to draw the vertical ellipse, then it would be a 2 offset. This is the vertical ellipse, so that we can draw multiple objects for the using the ellipse and circle while drawing on the form. This is the complete demonstration that how we can draw form on form different kinds of drawing objects. Now we will talk about the line object, line method, me.line. It also takes four coordinates. First one x1, y1. Let's suppose we say that this is 1000 1000, and the x2 y2 coordinate, let's suppose this is 4000 and 4000. This will draw a line. This is drawing a line. We can clearly see if this is not highlighted in the low resolution videos, I have to again increase the width or depth or draw mode of the form. This is draw mode of the form 10. We can increase it to 20. This will more highlighted. Okay, this is only 10. These are the four parameters of the line. First one is x1, second one is y1, third one is x2, and fourth one is y2. The next parameter is the color parameter. We can write here maybe green or maybe blue, adding standard color or user defined hexadecimal number here. And we can see the change. Green is not much more visible. We will change it to maybe blue. Okay, this is now much more clearly. These are the parameters that are normally used to draw the line on the form. If you want to draw the rectangle on the form, then we will use it P parameter as the block parameter. Block and block fill, two parameters are used at the end of the line function method. If we use it B, then it would be a rectangle. How this rectangle is created in this context or in this form? This is basically created with the this is created with the diagonal coordinates of the line. This is the actual line. From these diagonal coordinates, form is refilling or creating the other coordinates to draw the rectangle on the form. Okay, we can also use the last parameter as block field. If we use block field, then we can see that block is filled with the specified color. We can also change this color to any other color to see the VB yellow. We can see here this is a rectangle, so that we can create three kind of drawing objects with the help of built-in methods provided by the Visual Basic. First one is circle that contains different arguments. We can switch or rotate these arguments to create multiple kind of drawing objects, and we can also use these two standard methods to draw or to rotate any kind of animations on the Visual Basic form. And second one is we use here is the line method that also have some optional parameters that can be used to demonstrate other drawing objects on the Windows form. We can demonstrate it in such a way that we write here mouse move event. We write the code for the mouse move event. We write here if button is equal to VB left button, then form one or me dot circle, which one, the XY coordinate X Y, and the let's suppose radius is, and color is RGB R&D 255. This will take the random color whenever this will move. This is the end. If let's see what happened to the, we'll click on mouse and move this mouse. This is demonstrating much more effectively. Whenever we will move the mouse move event will draw the circle only if the left button is clicked. This will draw the circles only if the left button is clicked. We can clearly see. We can use this to write the text or animate the text that, let's suppose IT. We can see here. Tips, IT tips. Okay, these are the drawing modes that can be used in Visual Basic for drawing different kind of objects, drawing objects on the form. This can be done with the help of timer. Let's suppose we write here, drawn here timer, set its interval as 100, write here code me dot circle. Here x coordinate will be r and d multiply by form 1 or me dot width, and y coordinates will be me dot height radius will be R&D multiplied by 2000, and color will be RGB. I am going to totally randomize this functionality. R&D multiplied by 255. R&D multiplied by 255 and R&D multiplied by 255. Okay, let's see what is going on. Now this is the basically list parameters. This will the here. Okay, we can see here the circles are going to be drawn whenever timer clock is generated. R&D here will be the R&D to be specified. This can be seen here. We can also set the form me.drawWidth. drawWidth is equal to R&D multiplied by 20. Okay, invalid property. This is basically going to be zero or decimal. We have to specify here int plus one. Okay, now let's see what is going on. Oh, this is an amazing animation. We can also, we will discuss also other important topics regarding with the Visual Basic in our next lectures. Subscribe over it.